This is my Colt LE6920, and it's the rifle I decided to put my brand new cam from Silencer Co. on. This is the Spec War 556. I stated in an earlier video why I decided to go with this particular cam. And what you're about to see are the very first shots I'm going to take through this combination of rifle and silencer. I'm pretty excited about this, and I'll go ahead and shut up now so you guys can hear just how quiet or not quiet this is. Here we go. A lot of you guys know that we also have a Tavor in the family, as well as some other guns that I could have put this on. So why did I decide to put on the LE6920? And what is it like to actually shoot it with it on there? Well, it's very pleasant shooting. Some people thought it would be overgassed because this particular rifle, you know, a DI gun, you can't adjust the gas, so it is what it is. But I wasn't noticing a whole lot of gas in my face or anything like that. And we have this Tavor, and that would have made sense because the overall length of the Tavor is already so short, right? But then you get a really badly gassed in the face with the Tavor. I know they make aftermarket covers for it and whatnot, but go watch any video, Military Arms channel or others on YouTube, of people shooting the Tavor suppressed, and you'll always basically hear the same thing. It's nice to have it on there, but you get a lot of gas in the face. So I was pretty happy with this, taking it out, shooting it the first time. And as you can see, I'm sighting it in because it will change the point of impact. So I was really close. I mean, I was on the edge of the dot that I wanted to shoot on, and it just took a couple clicks on the aim point to get it sighted in the rest of the way for shooting it suppressed. This is an angled rifle target from Shoot Steel, and you guys know I love all their stuff. Now, this is the short range rifle target. You see it's angled down, and it doesn't ping very loud, as you'll see here in a second. And it also doesn't move around, but you can shoot it close, so that's the trade-off. Now, perhaps you can see the target in this shot. It's kind of in the middle of the frame, back there against the berm. And in this final shot coming up, it's all the way on the left side.